Welcome back. That's the SGX Nifty up 20 points, 10,775. Ashwani Gujral, Sudarshan Sukhani and Mitesh Thakkar now join us. Good morning, Ashwani. Your thoughts on how to approach trade today if we have a 20-25 point kind of uptick at start?
Well, good morning, and I think a bit of a downtrend has probably come to an end on Friday. Today, it's most likely that we stay in a 100-point Nifty range, 10,650, 10,750. So don't try to trade it like a trending market. Rather, it's more of a sideways market. So if we get back to 10,650, I would possibly buy. And similarly, on the Bank Nifty, anything closer to, say, 25,600 thereabouts, and that's where you need to buy. I think any move closer to, say, 10,780, 800, there you can possibly go ahead and go short. But today is more of a sideways session, so don't try to chase on either side.
Likewise for Nifty Bank, is it?
Yeah, similar, 26,500 to about 27,000, that sort of band.
Okay.
Because while we are underperforming, so if the world is going up, the chances are at best we may do sideways.
Okay. Well, Sudarshan Sukhani and Mitesh Thakkar also join in. Sudarshan, good morning. The Nifty is down about 350 points in the last six trading sessions. You've been indicating to us that this is a downtrending market. Do you anticipate more pressure?
Yeah, good morning, Sonia. Well, we have reached at least one of the initial targets of 10,600. We touched 10,620, which is more or less where the targets were. So at least this leg of the downtrend is over. Now the chances are that we will consolidate. The markets will not go down day relentlessly, hopefully not. And this is a process of consolidation. But after whenever this process of consolidation is over, I would expect 10,600 to be broken on the downside and lower levels to come. So the trade still seems to be to build up short positions again on large rallies. It's very difficult to define large rallies today. We'll have to spend a few days to find out where resistance comes. But if you don't have a position, then look for building short positions now using March options.
Okay, got that. Let's get Mitesh's view as well. I think Biocon is a stock that you should put on your radar. There are some important flashes coming. It looks like they've got, some green signals from the US FDA for some of their plants. The gravity of this, we will try and analyze in a minute. No observations for Unit 1 and even for the second plant, nothing very significant. So this should be an important positive for Biocon. But we'll come back, we'll try and reach some analysts on what this impact is. Mitesh, first up, good morning. How are you trading the indices?
Yeah, good morning, Lata. So my view has been negative. We did take some profits around 10,660, 650, but still have minor short positions open. The idea is that while we have kind of managed to hold on to support, which has held well on closing basis in the last 3 months, the structure is slightly turning on the negative side. So the bias is still on the weaker side, though as long as 10,660, 650 zone holds, there is always a chance of a pullback and a throwback on the upside. As long as the pullbacks don't get past levels of 10,770 to about 10,800, I think the idea should be to trade with some kind of negative bias. So rallies closer to about 10,770 would be ideal levels to go short with a stop at around 10,820 or thereabouts. So I would continue to use possibly today's gap up, and if we don't see a very strong follow through, then I think get into the short side of the trade around 10,750-770 zones.
Okay, fair enough. Let's now discuss individual stocks. Sudarshan, good morning. What's on your list?
Good morning. After many days, I have more buys than sells. At least that tells us that the mood of the market is a little better. Just a little better. Divis Live, see, there were stocks, Anuj, that fell on Friday and then bounced back by the closing. Those are the stocks we want to buy, and they should also be at the top of their charts. Three stocks qualify very quickly. Divis Live, it's a buying opportunity. It fell sharply, bounced back, and is at the top of its chart, which is it is not languishing. HCL Tech is another strong stock, same pattern, and it's an outperformer. That's a buy. And finally, Indigo has been a favorite for some time. That's a buying opportunity. So look at strong stocks to buy in a choppy market like this. Divis, HCL Tech, Indigo, two short sells, BEML. Actually, you could sell BEL also, BML also, BHEL also, all the Bs. But BEML is the selected stock today. And Godrej Consumer Products, again, it's a bear market there.
Okay. Mitesh, what about you? Also the stocks that you're looking at, but there are some more stocks which are in the news which could see relief today, maybe at DRL because of the US FDA lifting the warning letter, or even Tech Mahindra on the back of that impending buyback. Any of these news-based stocks that you would trade?
Tech Mahindra, definitely, yes. I think on Friday, we had a low of 780. And after the numbers, the gap had a support at about 775. So I think 780, 775 is unlikely to be broken in the short term. And there's a good chance that we'll see 840, 850 happening soon over here. So that's a buy with a stop at 775 or targets close to about 850. And I would be very comfortable buying here or adding on to the stock on any 5-10 point kind of a decline. That apart, I have slightly more sell ideas. My view still remains marginally negatively biased, and Colgate is one of them. 1250 should be a stop loss, 1200 should be a target. I also have a sell in Godrej Consumers, the candlestick pattern being quite negative. This one can be shorted around 668 with a stop at 681 for targets of 645. And a conditional sell in Pidilite. The structure is weakened, but the 200 average is at about 1092. So sell below 1090. Keep a stop at 1102 and look for targets of 1060. And I have one buy, that's on HCL Tech, which would recommend buying with a stop at 1048 for targets of 1080.
Okay. Ashwani, you also have Divis on your list, but more buys or sells for you?
See, trades will work on both sides. So okay. Buys and two sells. Divis Lab is a buy with a stop of 1600, target of 1665. Reliance is a buy with a stop of 1230, target of 1265. REC is a buy with a stop of 118, target of 126. Raymond is a sell with a stop of 691, target of 670. And HPCL is a sell with a stop of 221, target of 206.
Okay, well, we'll come back to you gentlemen for more details on individual stocks, or at least some more tech calls. But in the meantime, do watch out for the biggest event of the year, the News 18 Rising India Summit, to be held in New Delhi on the 25th and 26th of February.
This is one platform where you can catch all the biggest newsmakers of the country, from the Prime Minister Narendra Modi himself, BJP President Amit Shah is to address. Opposition Chief Ministers Kamal Nath and Bhupesh Baghel are also part of the list.
Okay, along with a whole host of union ministers will be Isha Foundation founder Sadhguru, Bollywood and sports icons like Deepika Padukone and former coach of the Indian cricket team Anil Kumble. Well, that's the News 18 Rising India Summit in New Delhi, which takes place on the 25th and 26th of February.